Yo, what's good, guys? My name is Cheyenne Giles. Thank you guys so much for all your support on Jump Around. Appreciate you guys supporting it, streaming it, buying it. Now I'm gonna show you how I made it. Let's go. So get out your seat and jump around. A little backstory on this. I actually finished this in March of 2019. Been sitting on it for 2 years, finally ready to put it out. I chose it because it's just one of those classic, timeless records. And I had a couple records before that were classics, but not of hip hop. So I was like, why don't I do a hip hop one? Listen to a bunch of hip hop classics. This one just really stuck out. It's just a timeless record. And people have done it, but they always drop it down into hip hop. And I wanted to keep it at house. So for this one, I just had to like be me, really. I wanted to keep it kind of like clubby, but can still be played on the festivals, just so like everyone has a chance to play it. So here we go. All right. So first, what do we got here? I think pretty sure this is just atmosphere. Oh, yeah, atmosphere. Then we got these bells. Pretty sure these are Nexus. Yeah, these are just Nexus. Some nice bells. I like to use Nexus. It's just easy on the CPU. They're really easy. Nexus 3 is just really super fast. I think right here is we just got some bass. Just a nice Reese bass in the back. Have that in most of my tracks. Some chords. Not doing anything. They're just really there to add some tension. Right here, I think we have like a really reverb out horn that I got off Splice. Very similar to the actual track itself, so that was really cool to find. Right here, I think we just have kind of a reversed the same thing, just kind of like flow it into the transition. What do we have right here? I'm pretty sure these are just a rave generator. It's like it's kind of like a VST, but it actually has like samples on it and stuff. So yeah, let me show you guys this. Yeah, this is a really cool thing. It's got all like the old school samples on it, and I love it for this kind of stuff. Actually, this is a perfect track for rave generator, and it just kind of breaks into the breakdown. Alright, so let's talk about the drop. The drum's pretty simple. I like to use a kick that's like kind of like a hip-hop-y kick, short, because I like to fill it up with my basses. I'm always stacking sounds in there, so I kind of like a short kick. This actually has two kicks. This one gives it that like the actual weight, and then this one is just like the top click, just to have it have that transient that just punch through. The claps, pretty simple, except they're stacked. They all have their own characteristic. Add them together to sound like this. Yeah. Moving on, let's go to the synths. First, we have Faceplant. This takes a lot of CPU. But I love it. I just started using this. It sounds good as it is. So other than that, we just have our bass on the drop. We have the sawtooth bass right here. Let me pull this up. There's not really any note changes on this. So what I did is just, I kind of have the notes be gliding off each other. So it sounds like that. Other than that, I think I just use a 3X aux, super easy sine wave sub bass. It sounds like this. That's what's gonna give you that low end feel. All right, let's talk about the B section. I always have A and B on my tracks, or like an A section and a B section, because I always try to hit them hard with the A section, have big synths, and then kind of ease off the gas on the B section, kind of give everyone a rest, a breather, and then hit them again with the A section. Right here, that's pretty sure is just some added layer to the bass just to give it a little different sound on this impact. Yeah, just added just a little change up. And then right here, let's see what we got. Always have my lasers. I use my lasers in the transitions a lot to also like kind of syncopate with the drums. And what else do we have? Yeah, kind of same to go to complement the lasers. I have kind of like a car alarm going off. And yeah, that's really like all there is to the track. I mean, Jump Around's already a timeless classic. I didn't really have to do too much to it. I just had to put my own spin on it and hopefully you guys like it. It's out now, it's available everywhere. I mean, it's festival and club ready. Hope you guys enjoy the tutorial. Go stream the record, go buy the record, support me. I really appreciate it. Yeah, peace, love you.